Hello and welcome back to the Time's Ticking YouTube channel. For those of you who are new, my name is Jake, and today I get to talk about the pocket watch of one of history's most notorious serial killers. So stick with me through this intro, and I'll lay down the details for the watch of Jack the Ripper. A unique development in one of history's most notorious unsolved crimes emerged in the early 1990s. This potential piece of evidence happened to be a horological one, a suspectly engraved gentleman's pocket watch from the 19th century, making itself known in 1993, not long after the alleged diary of a man named James Maybrick was examined as potential evidence in 1992. The watch has been seen by some as definitive proof of Jack the Ripper's true identity. Inscribed with the name J. Maybrick on the initials of all five of Jack the Ripper's victims, the watch as evidence comes across as incredibly compelling at face value. However, the previously presented diary was found to use language inconsistent with the 19th century. As well, the engravings on the pocket watch are difficult to date, and contain chemical compositions that would take a trained metalworking hand to plant on the piece. Despite these inconsistencies, many truly believe James Maybrick is the actual identity of Jack the Ripper. The most convincing argument to be made for this position is the pocket watch itself. And since we here at Time's Ticking are inclined towards time, we're going to take a closer look at some of its general anatomy. As well, we'll explore its place in the infamous case. No need to post a warning for the faint of heart here. The watch itself is a relatively benign aspect of the macabre mystery surrounding the Whitechapel's ruthless Ripper. The alleged serial killer-owned watch has a history all on its own. Originally built by watchmaker William Verity of Rothwell around 1847, 41 years before the Ripper crimes were committed, it's a fine traditional men's piece from the period. Verity's design is an 18-karat gold pocket watch that withstood decades of use. Though there isn't much information on its movement particulars, it's safe to assume that it employed a verge escapement, considering the date of its construction. After switching hands for over a century, the watch was presented publicly by one Albert Johnson in 1993 for forensic examination. Inscriptions on the inside of the timepiece were damning toward James Maybrick, but required a closer look to confirm them as evidence. Using an electron microscope, Dr. Stephen Turgoose of the Corrosion and Protection Center at the Manchester Institute of Science and Technology took a first crack at studying the Verity-made piece. Turgoose's conclusion essentially stated that the engravings revealed no conclusive evidence regarding their age. He did, however, mention that it would be difficult to create a forgery, without ruling out the possibility of a forgery entirely, thus keeping the mystery alive surrounding James Maybrick and his potential ownership of the notorious pocket watch. To this day, Maybrick remains a remarkable figure in the mystery surrounding Jack the Ripper. While his purported confession via his supposed journal was mostly debunked, his pocket watch remains a point of controversy. There's even a regularly updated and currently active Facebook page dedicated to Maybrick and the idea that he was the murderer, which features an image of the timepiece. Maybrick isn't the only suspect in a decent list of individuals, though. What's more, a longtime officer for Scotland Yard named Trevor Marriott believes that Jack the Ripper's true identity is lost due to a police cover-up. With difficulties surrounding unearthing older documents on the case, it seems the mystery won't be solved in any near future scenario. The grisly details of the crime still retain their infamy after generations of study and speculation. You're probably asking yourself, will this pocket watch make for any real incrimination in the future? Well, probably not. However, we'll continue to be intrigued by its role in the greater narrative concerning Jack the Ripper. I hope you enjoyed the video today. If you did, make sure to give it a like, and if you'd like to see more content from us, you can subscribe right here. And as always, if you need any help repairing your watch, the link to our website is right here. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you next time.